What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Dominic Rich, and in today's video we will be taking a look at the new proposed Champions League format that is set to be approved next month, March of 2021, and take effect from 2024. We have had this Champions League format for quite some time, and UEFA want to freshen things up because of a recent threat from a European Super League that is threatening to take teams from the UEFA Champions League to that Super League. So UEFA has to take action in order to persuade those teams to stay and participate in UEFA's competition instead of a breakaway Super League competition. So we are going to delve into this article and we are going to break it down to the T. So this article from Marca.com reads, "The new format will start in 2024 and will have 36 teams involved, respecting the national leagues by not playing on weekends or seeing a reduction of teams in each leagues." This has been reported by Juan Antonio Alcala on El Partidazo de Cope and Radio Marca, as UEFA have looked to address the threat of the proposed Super League. UEFA note that they need to make changes to update the Champions League, but they will respect three main areas. The Champions League will continue to be played during the week. Access to the Champions League will continue through national leagues, and the number of teams in national leagues will stay the same. The new format, which will start in 3 years' time, will continue until 2033. In the new Champions League, there will be a limit of 5 or 6 teams per country, and the extra 4 places will be determined in the following way: 2 clubs by the UEFA coefficient rankings, 1 extra for the 5th ranked league, the French league, and another place for the best league that doesn't have a representative. The first phase will be played from September to January, and each team will play 10 different games against different opposition. The top 8 will go straight through to the round of 16, and the 9th to 24th place will play a playoff to decide the other 8 teams in the round of 16. Games will take place on Tuesdays and Wednesdays, and there will be 4 Thursdays which will have Champions League matches. Just breaking down the new proposed Champions League format by UEFA, and money has a lot to do with it. More games mean more revenue for teams. 36 teams means that there's more opportunities for more teams. For example, England might have 6 teams, Germany 6, Italy 6, Spain 6. That's a lot of teams from the bigger leagues. And France will have an extra team, which they could go up to about 3 or 4. I think they currently have a guaranteed 3 teams. That was PSG, Marseille. There was PSG, Marseille, and Rennes in the Champions League this season, so they could go up to 4. So that would take the tally to about 28, leaving about 8 spots for teams from Portugal, teams from Scotland, teams from the Netherlands, and so on and so forth. So I know a lot of people would not actually support this one, because I've seen articles saying that we don't want another team, or the 5th and 6th place team from England. We want to see the champions of Scotland, or the champions of the Czech Republic, or Russia would also have a direct place as well. No remembering that one. And maybe you want to see a team from Denmark, Switzerland, you know, the champion from those other countries, a Croatia, you know, a Serbia, and not so much a 5th place and 6th place team from an England or from Spain. And the fact that they want to use UEFA coefficient rankings means that teams could automatically just enter into the Champions League even though they don't do well in their respective leagues. That's another thing. And another worry is the respective league cups. I did run across an article where the English FA might not actually approve the proposal from UEFA for this new format, because it means the League Cup will be in jeopardy. And the EFL gets a lot of their revenue from the sponsors of the Carabao Cup and everything. Well, the sponsors of the League Cup, which Carabao was a sponsor, and I think Papa John's are getting involved in everything. So something's got to give, and maybe one of the local cup competitions will have to make way for this new proposed Champions League format. It's a whole lot of games though. It sounds very exciting that your team Once they're in the Champions League, they have 10 extra games guaranteed against other European oppositions. I doubt they will be playing teams from the same national association. Like, you won't see a City against Liverpool in the group stages. Who knows? Who knows? But I doubt. If you have, 32 other teams to play, why play against teams from your same association during the group phase? But it is an exciting prospect, but it's just more. You see what I mean? It's just more and more and more football. It's just hard to digest, man. You see what I mean? We're trying to manage the very, very busy schedule, but yet UEFA keeps bringing more and more and more for the sake of revenue. More money. It's just about bringing in more and more money, man. It's all about the money. That's what it's all about. So this is my reaction to the new proposed format. I think the Champions League do need a little refresher, to be honest. And we must be open to new things. But the way things are in the world right now, I don't know if they would be the same in 2024. So let's see how this one actually works out. It is said that it's going to be approved in March. So I will be back with a follow-up video in March. I've wanted to make this video for some time, but because of a few technical issues, it didn't actually happen. But these are my thoughts now. Share yours down below on the new proposed Champions League format. Let me know if you like it or you don't. Let me know what repercussions would it have on the respective leagues. And let me know what benefits and disadvantages it would have. Let me know the pros and cons, please. So I'm your boy Dominic Rich, coming to you with another one. Make sure you subscribe if you're new around here. Like the video if you like it. And until next time, from your boy Dominic Rich, thanks for watching. Peace out. Rich Squad.